what I want to know, out of all the areas around Waycross that you have tested, and I don't know how many people have told y'all they're sick, out of all the people in all the areas, have you found anybody that was legitimately sick from all of these chemicals? That you believe is sick?
There's so much, there's so many factors that can make anyone sick. Right, and number it's a little bit things that you're getting. And, and the kind of things that we want to get, Georgia's want to improve the health survey data, things that we've been looking for, even we were talking about whether we have high detections or low detections, or whether or not the existence of a compound in the environment is a problem at all, can you trace that back? We can't trace that back, which is why we have to go off those generic numbers or specific numbers to give us an idea of what might actually be a problem. But no, there's no way to make that connection. But the reality is that you're right, people are hurting. There is a collective sense that there is a problem here. That there are people who are sick, there are people who are suffering, and we're not consensual to that. And if we found a problem, if EPA found a problem, if Georgia found a problem, anything, we would clean it up. We want to clean it up with you. We're not deliberately not sampling something. We're not trying to cut and run and go back to Atlanta, go back home. That's not the goal. We're here because we do this job because we love to do this job, because we think it's important and we think you guys are important as well. So the when I say that EPA can't do anything based on what we found, when Georgia says that they're not going to continue certain sampling in the wells for the residences because they didn't find anything, it doesn't mean that they don't want to clean things up that are there. But we have to go where the information leads us. If we don't have direct information to suggest that something is there, then it's a waste of effort to just go looking, hoping that we're going to find something. We have to clue in on things. And even though, like you said, we can't tie back illnesses to a direct cause, when the public health service goes back and looks at data and looks for trends, looks for things that shouldn't be there because there's something different in a community based on what their data says there should be, then that is the kind of data that EPD or EPA would need to focus in and try and find something. When we get a report of bad smells when it rains, or shoes in the air, we're not sampling it, we're not looking at it because we don't care, and we're not deliberately avoiding it, and we're not only coming on sunshiny days because we don't want to be here when it rains, we're just not here all the time. But I think it was a great offer that Jane made. Public health service does have someone in this county that does want to come and take a whiff and confirm and say, no, this is not just shouting public meeting, this is real. We need to come